I'm Kat Timpf with National Review. Researchers are arguing that dodgeball is not just a harmless children's game, but actually a sinister activity that teaches them oppression. According to a National Post article, three education theorists will give a presentation at the upcoming Canadian Society for the Study of Education meeting in Vancouver and argue that dodgeball is, quote, miseducative because it makes kids learn that they should be oppressing weaker people or something. My reaction to this? Honestly, it's so stupid that I don't even know where to start. When I was a kid, I really enjoyed dodgeball because it was the only activity where I got to sit around and relax because I wasn't good at sports. I used to get hit by the ball, often even on purpose, and then get to just chill on the sidelines. It was awesome. At no point during any of this did I start to feel like I was somehow inferior or powerless because other kids were better at hitting people with a ball than I was. I also never saw any of the kids who were good at it become violent or domineering in any way. I know these researchers would probably say that I just haven't thought or learned enough about it. The truth is, though, too much thinking can often make things more complicated than they really are. Yes, dodgeball encourages competitiveness. Yes, the stronger, more athletic kids are going to be more successful. But what game doesn't have winners and losers? I mean, if we thought about all children's games through this sort of social justice lens, kids wouldn't be allowed to play any of them. After all, couldn't you argue that games like tag and hide and seek encourage stalking behaviors? Or that Simon Says teaches women that they have to do what men say? I could go on. But I'm actually kind of concerned that one of these researchers might take one of my comparisons seriously. I'll just leave it at this. Dodgeball is just a game, and I will give you $1,000 if you can find even a single student who has become some kind of abusive tyrant because of it.